Let's do a quick makeover using only an iPad. If you, like me, have never been a fan of lifeless computer renderings, their complexity, technical aspects and time-consuming nature, and would love to draw your ideas in a more flexible, unique and easy way, then you're gonna love today's rendering approach, which is called hand-drawn sketching. Today we'll be creating a mood board and a simple 3D view of a small office area, something between a complex 3D drawing and a quick sketch called a bird's eye view, the easiest perspective to draw. It's ideal if you need to visualize your space quickly, on the go, and directly with your client. Tools needed: an iPad, an Apple Pencil, and the Procreate app. And not, I'm not sponsored by any of them, just a super happy user here. Let's go! I'm gonna start my makeover by collecting ideas on Pinterest, the colors and furniture arrangements I like. A brief intro about the office area we're redesigning today, which is my own home office, as you might have guessed. I'm not planning any radical changes, just a couple, such as refreshing the wall color, adding more storage and personal touch to the room. I'd like to keep my desk, it's from Hay, my sitting chair from HK Living, the little cabinet from Cartel, and of course, this fabulous wall of inspiration, that's what I call it. One of the ideas is to change the position of this wall a little bit and build it on the other side near where you guys are currently standing, well, where the camera is. Since the position of this desk stays, because I need lots of space for my lighting in front of it, I need to free up some space here on the left. Currently, there is a shelf here with all the books and magazines, which blocks the way to the window. Let me actually show it to you. And I already have an idea of where to put all the books after the shelf goes away. So I'm gonna hang a corner shelf on the other side of the room where my filming gear is to utilize every inch of the room, because it is indeed very small. And now let's prepare a floor plan of the room for our future drawing. First up, to create a sketch to scale based on it. Procreate has a genius function, which is the number one option for interior design. It is called a drawing guide and I'm currently using it. So our floor plan is now to scale, and the next step is to prepare a mood board which our drawing will be based on. This mood board will contain the final design ideas we found in Pinterest and which we're going to try out during the drawing process. This is a huge benefit of drawing digitally. We can play around with ideas and concepts as much as we want without redrawing the sketch. I'm gonna show you how later in the video. And we have finally come to the drawing part. Before starting sketching, I'd like to take a screenshot of the floor plan for a separate file, since the final drawing will be a separate canvas, not the file with the mood board we're currently in. what we've created so far. I'm gonna stop right here since I don't know what my back wall will look like yet. And I'll probably experiment a little bit with it during the drawing part. I already see the first adjustment. I want to move the desk further from the sideboard and closer to the window. Since I was working in separate layers and the perspective is very convenient for revisions, I was able to move the table like this. Speaking of revisions, remember at the beginning of the video I told you about Procreate being convenient for playing around with ideas? Well, I wasn't really sure about the height of the sideboard, so what I did was I saved both of the variants and tried both of them out in my drawing. Based on the result, I decided to pick the lower version. You also saw me changing the canvas size. That feature is called crop and resize and allows you to adjust the canvas size like literally at any time. Something paper drawing doesn't have, right? And this is how we experiment with colors. Knowing how to work with layers and their logic is key. If you aren't sure about, let's say, the wall and furniture color, this is how you can experiment with different options. This bird's eye view type of drawing helps us see the entire space perfectly and play around with different ideas super quickly. Here's a short video on layers once again for this particular drawing. And the bird's eye view is done! The before the initial floor plan, the design mood board, and this is our after. Honestly, designing and drawing design mood boards and bird's eye views are probably my favorite drawing types, as they contain so many details, textures, and decor elements, which is basically a paradise for designers. And you know what? I prepared another, even more detailed design and drawing video tutorial for you. So, are you ready to continue your sketching journey with me? If so, you're invited to my free drawing workshop where you'll be creating an interior collage in a mixed technique, meaning that some of the elements will be integrated into your drawing and some of them will be hand-drawn. This is where to attend, and of course the link can also be found in the description below the video. Sad, but we've come to the end of this video. It was truly a pleasure to draw with you today and show some of the hacks that digital drawing has to offer. Believe me, this is just a tiny part of it. If you liked this kind of makeover, there are other tutorials like this one on my channel where I designed two kitchens, another office area, and a bedroom. I'll put the links in the description below the video too, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.